Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My24 is brought to you by Badger Max Premium Sports Drinks. Drink it to the max. Menards. Save big money at Menards. Wisconsin Lutheran College. American Family Insurance. And by Durzon and Menard. They work for the average Joe. Additional support has been provided by the U.S. Army, the Marines, Goodwill, and Sports Radio 105.7 FM, The Fan.
Welcome to the Badger Max Thursday Night Lights High School Football Game of the Week. We are live at Jasquidge Stadium as Kenosha Indian Trail takes on Kenosha Tremper in the Southeast Conference Showdown. Thanks for joining us. I'm Mike McGivern. I'm with Sports Radio 105.7 FM, The Fan, and this is The Fan Pregame Show. I'm joined by the two head coaches tonight, Mike McKay with Kenosha Indian Trail, Frank Matrice with Kenosha Tremper. Coach, let me start with you. Thanks a lot for having us come down. Coach, you 1-0 in conference. Had a really tough non-conference schedule. Wondering how you're feeling about this year's team.
You know, I think we're really growing into things, gaining some confidence. I thought last week is exactly what the doctor ordered, and just hope to keep that rolling.
Coach, same question. Tough start, not exactly what you were hoping for. How you feeling about this year's group? Got a lot of fight in them.
Yeah, we do. I mean, we're a little banged up right now, and that's one thing that, you know, we got to overcome some of the injuries, but hopefully we come out tonight and play a good football game.
Hey, let's say with you, this conference, you know, it seems at times a little bit top heavy when you're looking at Franklin, Oak Creek's playing awfully well right now, and the rest of the conference fighting to get into that playoff berth, and I'm thinking the conference is a little bit better than maybe some people give it credit to.
I think our league is very good. I think we have great coaches and, you know, very good football teams. And, you know, you got to play each other week in and week out. It's a football game, so you got to come prepared and ready to play.
Hey, Mike, same question for you. Conference-wise, you know, it's people will talk about it. It's top-heavy. I think it's a pretty solid conference. Your thoughts on that?
I think there's real good parity in the league this year. I think you're going to see a lot of exciting games, and it's going to be tough. There might be some good football teams on the outside looking in come playoff time.
Yeah, I agree. Mike, last question for you. The strength of the program, numbers, how is the program at Indian Trail?
Good. Our numbers are up a little bit from last year. I think we got 146 in the program, so you know, it's up a little bit from last year, and we're excited. We feel like we've got things rolling now.
Hey, last question on your side, but I'm going to go to you, Kyle. Eighth grader playing a little linebacker. What else do you play?
Fullback.
Linebacker and fullback. The youth program that you're playing in, how are you guys doing?
We're doing good.
Yeah, you're playing well?
Yes.
Yeah, you're proud of this guy, huh?
I am.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm proud of both of my children, and very lucky. They're honor roll students, which is number one with their mother and I, and a very good football player.
How the strength in the youth program and some of the kids coming up, with the numbers of, you know, Tremper, how are things for you?
Good. Numbers are good for us. And you know, football, like I told you before the game, is at its safest element it's been. And I'm really, you know, I think the technology, the equipment, and everything is as good as it gets right now. And I encourage kids, you know, go out, learn to play the game the right way, and play it the safe way.
Do you know, we're telling that story too on some of the radio shows that I do. And I'm telling you, Coach, sometimes I get pushback, but I believe that as well. I believe this game is as safe as it's ever been.
Well, I agree with you, and you know, I think it's a great game, and I think there's a lot more to just the game that we're teaching these young men to go out and be good people and good citizens.
Hey, I'm going to cut you guys loose. Thanks a lot. I appreciate it. We're going to get to a break. Other side of the break, Terry Kelly, John Weiser, we'll get you the keys to the game. This is the Badger Max Thursday Night Lights High School Football Game of the Week, only on My24.
The Indian Trail Hawks taking on the Kenosha Tremper Trojans. With Terry Kelly, John Weiser. Oh. Welcome back to Charles Jaskiewicz Stadium. We're on the campus of Indian Trail Academy in Kenosha. A Southeast Conference matchup tonight. The Indian Trail Hawks taking on the Kenosha Tremper Trojans. With Terry Kelly, John Weiser with you. Glad you're along tonight. It's great to be back in Kenosha as we feature this game here this evening. Tremper looking for their first win of the year. Indian Trail picked up their first win last week.
Right, and Tremper needs, they got to get to four wins in the conference, so they can't let this game go by. Indian Trail got that big win last week against Park. They want to continue rolling.
Let's talk about some key players we're going to keep an eye on tonight. First for the Hawks, their quarterback, Ian Chapman.
Ian Chapman runs well, read option, throws the ball well. Key to their whole offense. In front of him, they've got Jake Simar, outstanding offensive plus defensive lineman, plays both ways.
Indian Trail's got a pretty good defense as well.
They've got, you know, Davion Nixon, excellent player, and then in the back defensive backfield, Josie Rodriguez covers the pass well, comes up quickly to stop the run.
Tremper wants to get their running game going. Who are they going to look to there?
Well, they've got the offensive line led by Kyle Rickman, does an outstanding, Richter makes excellent decisions in the line of scrimmage, and then Ben Rollman, because he's all over the field. You might see him at quarterback, you might see him as a wide receiver. Excellent, excellent ball player.
And on the defensive side for the Trojans,
Siondae Stewart going to be a key to trying to stop this offense, Ian Chapman, and you've got Liam Gretchen, got to make sure we get that name right, who has really had a fine year, according to Coach Matrice.
That leads us now to our Badger Max keys to the ball game. What do you have drawn up?
Well, Coach Mike McKay said we have to cut down our mental and physical errors. They really inhibited us the first two games. They want to find a way to get Christian Young and Josh Pritzelfinger involved in the passing game, and then his advice to his team: stop trying to do too much. Concentrate on your assignments.
And for the Trojans tonight, what do they need to do?
They have to stop Ian Chapman. If they don't stop him, it could be a long evening. Other thing they want to make sure they do is they have to find a way to take advantage of the aggressiveness of Indian Trail. And then finally, they need to win the turnover battle. They've got to create some and not give it up.
The Hawks have won all three matchups thus far, the last two games by a combined score of 7 points. Should be an exciting one here tonight. We've got the kickoff for you coming up next on My24. Stadium in Kenosha tonight. The Tremper Trojans taking on the Indian Trail Hawks. International anthem tonight sung by McKenna Rookdy, a student here at Indian Trail Academy.
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. Hammer rockets, red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet
McKenna Rookdy, a student here at Indian Trail Academy, with our national anthem and our cadets provided by the Kenosha Military Academy here at Indian Trail. Now, prior to tonight's game, Andrew Burns of Badger Max Premium Sports Drinks, along with tonight's officiating crew and team captains, took part in the pregame coin toss. We are proud and excited to have Badger Max, a Wisconsin product, as a big part of our Thursday Night Lights telecast this season, and we thank you very much, Andrew. And that coin toss tonight won by the Tremper Trojans, and they have deferred their decision to the second half. And Indian Trail will take the football to begin our ball game here tonight. Neil Bruner, one of the more veteran officials in Southeast Wisconsin,
heading up our officiating crew here tonight.
Yeah, he works all levels, high school, NCAA, excellent official, well-respected. He certainly will have, he and his crew have this game in complete control.
Our game ball will be delivered by Sergeant Nicholas Ebert, a recruiter from Racine, and along with him is Mike Maritato, a Marine enlistee from Indian Trail Academy.
Neil Brenner, thank you. Thank you. Neil Brenner, thank you. Enjoy the game.
The weather has held out here tonight. The rain has held off. It rained throughout the middle part of the day, but we had some breaks of sunshine here late this afternoon. We will be without a scoreboard here for a while tonight. They've had some difficulty with that scoreboard. They are working on it. They're trying to try and get that fixed as our game begins. There you see it. I was expecting to see Eric Corbett up that ladder trying to work on it, but I hear he doesn't really do too much around here.
Well, perhaps using flashcards to let us know what's going on. We'll see if that becomes the case.
Tremper in the white jerseys, Indian Trail in the black jerseys tonight. Back deep for the Hawks, Bryant Jones and Christian Jones. And Ben Rollman's kick will bounce at the 20. He'll be picked up far side by Bryant Jones, circles back near hash mark, gets across the 20, out to the 25-yard line. Got a 5-yard return, good coverage on the play. Alex Witt coming down on special teams to make the play for the Trojans. So we'll get our first look at offense here tonight for the Hawks. Led by quarterback Ian Chatman. We've heard nothing but good things from their coaching staff this week about Chatman and the way he runs the game.
We watched him at practice on Monday on Labor Day, and while the offense was going through some little blocking schemes, he was off on his own with two of his running backs practicing the read option.
Stacks two by each side here on this first down play. And they'll give it to Pretzelfinger. Josh Pretzelfinger with the run. Nice run out to the 30-yard line. Gain of about 5 on the play. One of our keys tonight, trying to get him more involved in the offense.
Right, and you can see right now that Indian Trail is in a hurry-up mode. They want to try to put pressure right off the bat on that Tremper defense.
Second and 5 from the 30 near hash mark. Again, they'll spread him out. Single back is Pretzelfinger. Movement and a flag. Yep. Little jump that time. Both players jumped. That was Alfredson, the slot man here on the near side, that jumped out of his stance.
Yeah, we'll have to see. One of the things we noted before the game is that the Tremper Trojans have got about 4 or 5 guys going both ways. We'll have to see how much of a factor that becomes in the game and whether the hurry-up offense that they're going to use is going to have an impact.
Turns into a 2nd and 10 now, back at the 25-yard line, and it'll be Chatman. Off the read that time, the zone read, takes it up, gets those 5 yards right back on the fake to Pretzelfinger.
That zone read puts tremendous pressure on your defensive end. It depends what you've given him as an assignment, whether he's going to crash or whether he's going to try to play off the option pitch.
Griffin was there to make the nice play for Tremper. There's your starting offense for Indian Trail. A fire over the middle, complete. Christian Jones with the reception, and it should be enough for a first down out across the 35 to the 37-yard line.
Coach McKay said they wanted to get Christian Jones. They wanted to get Josh Pritzelfinger more involved in the passing game. Spread that ball around.
Chapman wants to throw again on first down. Going deep, has a man out there, makes the catch at the 30. He'll take it all the way. Christian Jones for the score. Indian Trail strikes first on a beautiful thrown ball by Ian Chatman to Christian Jones, his 3rd touchdown of the season.
Now last year he was 2nd in the Southeast Conference in total yards on receptions, so he is a formidable target.
Watch it once again as this play developed. Beautifully thrown ball led Jones perfectly in stride as he got behind the defender. It was Liam Peterson back there as a linebacker who got beat on the play. The tack on for the extra point. It is up, and it is good. Barely 2 minutes in, and Indian Trail has struck first on a 63-yard touchdown pass from Chatman to Jones.
One of the problems that Tremper has had during the first 3 games is being able to respond offensively. Now when you give up that opening score, now how is it going to affect your offense? Are they going to respond, or are they going to tighten up and say, boy, would we have to try to do the whole thing for us right away?
That's also been a problem, giving up the big play. Last week it was a 95-yard touchdown pass from Horlick that did them in the early part of that ball game. The big play, really, Horlick had 179 yards of total offense, 95 coming on that one touchdown play.
They had the quarterback for Horlick trapped in the end zone. Suddenly the cornerback came steaming up, let his man run free, and there the 95-yard touchdown pass, and really that was the difference in the game.
Three plays, the 60-yard touchdown reception. Armani Ray and Siandre Stewart will stand deep here for Tremper.
The clock will be kept on the field. The score will be kept on the field. We apologize once again.
Brad Close, a senior for the Hawks, will do the kicking here.
Brad Close.
He'll drive a low liner. It'll skim around. It'll be picked up at far side. Stewart across the 20 and buried there. Short return just across the 20-yard line for Siandre Stewart. Stepping up, R.J. Yenerol. And there's the starting lineup for Tremper on offense, led by Alec Becker, the quarterback. We'll keep an eye on here tonight. We talked about Kyle Richter and at center, and Kyle Eckelberg is the left guard.
Right. Kyle Richter is good, but he's not playing two positions.
First and 10, 21-yard line. Becker will hand it off. They'll try a run off left side. That's Peterson, and he'll be driven back maybe a yard.
Peterson is a good-sized running back. He's 6 feet, 210 pounds, and Coach McKay thought they were going to have to find a way to put a stop to his plunges into the line.
Brad Close and Michael Capodarco were in on that stop for the Hawks. Gain of two on the play. We're going to set up a second and eight here for Tremper. They trail 7-0. 63-yard touchdown pass by Indian Trail on the third play from scrimmage tonight. Now they'll roll the tight ends. They'll set up a slot receiver here on the near side from the gun. And Becker will throw behind Rollman, who is open at the 30-yard line.
If you watch that play, you see Davion Nixon, a 6'6", 257-pound junior, get his hand up, blocking the way. As a junior, he's already getting some looks. Imagine a young man with that frame is going to be quite appealing to a lot of defensive coaches at the college level.
So third down and long here for Kenosha Tremper.
Again,
Becker will work from the gun, third and seven. Ball at the 24-yard line. Becker will roll right with some time. He'll keep it himself. Tries to get to the chains, but will be pulled down behind short.
Yes.
Tried to roll to his right that time. Let's head down to the sideline and Mike McGivern.
Hey, guys, listen to the offensive line coach for Indian Trail. He wants that pace to get a little bit quicker. Happy, obviously, with the first drive. But he said, boys, we got to get a little bit quicker, make sure we make no mistakes, and let's keep the pace going. I think they want this to be a track meet tonight, boys.
Personal foul call here on Indian Trail, so Tremper will get their first down. That'll move the ball out to the 42-yard line. So first down by penalty here for Tremper, extending this drive. We're about 9.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Again, we're without a scoreboard, so the time is being kept on the sideline by the officials tonight. Out of the eye formation. And Peterson will get the call, breaks it over the right side across midfield, tripped up just as he made the midfield strap. Josh Wayand, the senior, led the conference in tackles and interceptions a year ago, makes the stop for the Hawks.
Peterson followed the block of Travail Lee, a 6'4", 310-pound senior. That's a nice gentleman to have you leading through the hole.
Again, this season, first downs are sponsored by Wisconsin Lutheran College, located in Milwaukee, a comprehensive Christian college offering 37 undergraduate majors and accelerated degree completion program for adult learners and graduate degree options. Learn more at wlc.edu. First and 10 from the 48. Peterson again trying to get the right side and does. Inside the 45, down to the 41-yard line. Gain of 7 on the play for Peterson.
Peterson made a nice adjustment there as the cornerback came up to close the outside. He planted that foot, turned upfield, got an 8-yard gain out of it.
And we want to remind you that the Badger Max Thursday Night Lights is available streaming live online. Log on to my24milwaukee.com and click on the Thursday Night Lights link. You can also find complete game videos and photos from this season's games. Second and a good 2 here for Tremper. They fumble the snap. Becker able to cover it up. Still on the turf, and it's recovered by Indian Trail. Brad Close with the fumble recovery right at the 40-yard line. And that's the problem that Tremper has had all season long, summed up right there.
Coach Matrice says they've been plagued by the turnover, that the scores in a couple of the games are misleading because they were down in scoring position but gave the ball up.
The game is simple, Terry, center to quarterback. That's how it all starts. And the exchange there cost the Trojans a possession. Indian Trail with the takeaway. They'll stack 3 receivers here to the near side from their own 40-yard line. Chapman throws it out to Jones. Jones with some running room, 45 to midfield and shoved out of bounds there. Gain of 12 on the play for Jones off the reception from Chapman.
Coach McKay has stayed true to his statements. He's going to try to get the ball to Christian. Christian was a state qualifier in track, so he knows he wants to make use of that speed to the outside.
Christian Jones caught that touchdown pass to set up the 7-0 game. He'll catch it again here in the flat. Makes the first man miss down the far sideline. There he goes. Christian Jones down the far sideline will take it into the house. 48 yards for Christian Jones. 2 big plays, and Indian Trail has stretched their lead to 13.
When you watch the replay, you can see how apparent that speed is. One of the Kenosha Tremper defenders actually has the angle on him, but his burst takes him right past him.
Boy, he is just quick with a capital Q down that far sideline for Christian Jones. Second touchdown reception tonight. Close to tack on the extra point. It is low, and it made it through. Just stuck over the crossbar. 14-0. Indian Trail, 2 big plays, capitalizing off the Tremper miscue, the turnover into points. 3 catches now for 120 yards and 2 touchdowns for Christian Jones.
This is Coach Matrice's worst nightmare coming true. They finally were moving the ball, gaining some yards, and then the turnover stops them dead in their tracks.
And again, we're without a scoreboard tonight, so they are working on trying to get that fixed and told that as soon as it and get that set up, hopefully before the end of our ball game tonight.
You don't realize how dependent you become on the scoreboard until you don't have it available to you.
Well, now if you're Tremper here, you're down 2 scores off 2 big plays, and you've got to really suck it up here as a player and try and stay positive. A lot of game left here, but again, the way things have transpired in the first 3 games now for Tremper.
You can't get out of your game plan. They were running the ball. They were making some good yardage, so you don't want to start just chucking it up to try to get back in quickly. But what's their mindset? Are they saying to themselves, oh boy, here it goes again?
3 receptions, 120 yards, and 2 touchdowns. That's a game for most people. That's just the first 3 minutes of this first quarter. Close will drive one into the turf. It'll skip around, and Kekeson will pick it up there.
That kickoff was recovered by number 85.
Alex Witt, excuse me, covering that one up. So the short kick will give Tremper pretty good field position here. Their second possession tonight. Their first one ended in the fumble, which was turned into 7 points by Indian Trail.
Yeah, the last thing they can do now is give the ball right back to Indian Trail. They need to drive the field. They need to make sure that they can establish just who they are.
Alec Becker at quarterback from the gun. 3 receivers to the right side. Kekeson, the single receiver here to the near side. Looking that way, fumbled the snap once again, and Becker will have to take it up for just a couple. May have taken the eye off that snap coming back to him, juggled it, and that took the timing away. He was looking for Kekeson here on a slant.
you know, on the year, Becker has been a fairly effective passer, 25 of 48, throwing for two touchdowns. And he needs to just settle down, let the game come to him, not get too nervous.
So gain of two, second down, a long eight here for Tremper. Ball at the 29-yard line once again from the gun, Becker. He'll hand it off, Peterson. Peterson taking tacklers with him across the 32 out to the 33-yard line. Gain of about four. It'll bring up third and medium here for Tremper. We've got a player down for Indian Trail.
Looks like Capodarco.
Yeah, he made the tackle, and he is down with some sort of a right leg injury.
Yeah, he gives him nice size inside, a 210-pound senior. They, you know, want to make sure that they, if they try to control the inside running by Peterson, that they are able to have his services.
So try and look at Capodarco. Mike McKay, the head coach out there, along with the training staff. One more look at the play. Peterson, as he made it through there. It's right there. His ankle kind of turned. Back up under his own power, but we'll head to the sideline, and we'll get our first visit tonight with Kara.
Thank you very much, guys. I've got Rhoda Woolley with Wisconsin Lutheran College with me. You've done some traveling with some of your students. Can you tell us about that?
Absolutely. We spent 3 weeks in Africa this summer working with some schools in Zambia, and then a group of us went down to the Caribbean and worked with some schools in the island of Grenada. So.
That's wonderful. And you guys have your Discovery Days. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. On September 25th, we have Discovery Day at Wisconsin Lutheran College, where students and their families are welcome to come and tour the campus and talk to our admissions counselors, talk to members of the faculty, current students, and just learn more about Wisconsin Lutheran College. You can register at wlc.edu, and that's on September 25th.
Well, thank you so much for joining us tonight and for our Thursday Night Lights, and back up to you guys.
Kara, thank you so much. And that's a Wisconsin Lutheran College first down by Leon Peterson, out to the 41-yard line.
They've been making Peterson a steady diet in terms of their offense.
There's a theme over there in that Tremper sideline. I'll let you figure that one out.
I told there would be no math.
First and 10 from their own 41. Becker from the gun with time. Steps left, throws left, and overthrows his intended target. Looking to go downfield that time. Looking for Kyle Griffin, extra tight end out there. Griffin, 6'1", 195, and a senior.
I think that time, Alec Becker, if he had a chance to see it again, might have kept the ball. He might have been able to get the first down on his own.
Ben Rollman will bring the play in from the far sideline. His father, Peter, played football here in Kenosha. Know the Rollman family. Went to school with Ben's aunt. That's how far back I go with that family.
I'm sure the aunt doesn't want to hear that. No. It was far back.
We won't give years. We'll just say we go back a ways. Peterson off the inside handoff, and he struggles to get back to the line of scrimmage. May have eked out a yard. And there was Simar again, Jake Simar. We talked about him in the pregame. He sometimes will go both ways on offensive line and defensive line using that wrestler attitude that he has.
Excellent wrestler, and Davion Nixon was also in there. They present a pretty formidable front four for Indian Trail.
These are the downs Frank Matrice Jr. wants to stay away from. Third and nine. Kekison will come here to the near side. Three receivers to the far side. Hard count. Nearly got him to jump. Becker over the middle, and it's juggled and dropped. Nearly intercepted through the hands of the safety, Andrew Masters. And so Tremper will punt this one away. Looking for Griffin once again, but it was overthrown. And he just shot him too far on a high, and just a bad pass there. Let's head down to Mike McGivern one more time.
Hey, guys, two things. Defensive side, Coach McKay addressed that late hit. He said, enough of that. We're not doing that again. Offensively, obviously, they think they have Tremper on their heels, and they're going to try to put their foot on the throat and end this thing early tonight.
All right, Mike, thank you. The punt by Ben Rollman inside the 15-yard line. Got the nice bounce that time.
The ball will be spotted at about the 13.
Chapman tonight, 4-for-4 for 132s. So we'll take our break here, our mid-quarter break. Indian Trail, two big plays. Christian Jones with two touchdown receptions. The Hawks lead Tremper 14-0. Our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights in Kenosha on My24. Indian Trail on top of Tremper, our Thursday Night Lights, presented by Badger Max. Jaskiewicz Stadium on Kenosha's west side, Indian Trail Academy. Chapman will swing it out here near side, completes to Alfredson. Max Alfredson up the field across the 15, short of the 20 and driven out of bounds there. So Chapman spreading it around, 5-for-5 now, including the two touchdown passes to Christian Jones.
Very quick release. He delivers a ball that's right on the mark.
And
Scott Flood, there's going to have to figure out, how do I get the Tremper defense to respond a little bit more quickly to what they're seeing play out in front of them.
Kyle Kekeson credited with the stop. Gain of about 6, second down along 4. Chapman wants to throw again into the slot once again. Jones with a nice catch.
Christian Jones,
three receptions now, the only one that would not go for a touchdown there.
Michael Mertz on the tackle.
That'll be enough for a Wisconsin Lutheran College first down out to the 30-yard line. Time Pretzelfinger. Stop for a short gain. Good defense that time by Tremper.
You can see that the Indian Trail Hawks are giving their future opponents a lot to watch. They're spreading the ball around. If you start just concentrating on defending the pass, you're going to be wide open for that run, especially when you had Ian Chapman pulling the trigger on the read option.
Chapman again. Now scrambles right. Toss it downfield, looking for Jones, and it's incomplete. His first incompletion of the night. Trying to safety valve that time out to Jones as he was under pressure, providing that pressure. Kyle Griffin back there for Tremper.
Right. It's essential now that they get the stop on third down, get the ball back, try to exchange field position, tilt the field to their liking so Tremper can get back in the game.
Third and 9. Ball at the 30-yard line of the Hawks. Chapman fires sideline go route, completes the pass and the first down out to the 48-yard line. Armani Carmichael with the catch out to the 46-yard line. That'll be a 16-yard pickup and another Wisconsin Lutheran College first down.
I think that's the fourth different receiver that Chapman's hit so far. So as you pointed out, he is spreading the ball around.
They'll go with the hurry up. Play action fake. Chapman will keep it. Breaks a tackle at the line of scrimmage across midfield to Tremper territory to the Trojan 47-yard line.
Well, Coach Mike McKay says that Ian Chapman is a real student of the game. He does film study, always working on his little techniques, really has made this offense go.
Pretzelfinger up the middle. Pretzelfinger breaks a tackle. Breaks another one inside the 30 down to the 25-yard line. Pretzelfinger taking defenders with him. Jots Pretzelfinger, a 5'7", 164-pound senior, a battering ram up the middle.
Right. He was not going to be denied. He just kept churning.
One, two, almost three tackles. They'll get it into the end zone as we're looking at the replay, and they get it out to Armani Carmichael. Third touchdown pass thrown by Chapman in the quarter. An Indian Trail piling it on now, 20-0.
Coach McKay said he was looking for Carmichael to have one of those breakout games. Much to the chagrin of Coach Matrice, that's unfortunately coming true.
Armani Ray was the defender. Just got that ball over his fingertips into Carmichael's hands. Close for the extra point. It is up and through. An Indian Trail making a statement. 21 unanswered here in this first quarter. One more look at the touchdown pass. Again, just over the fingertips of Armani Ray, the cornerback back there.
Yeah, it looks as though the DB had planted his feet, didn't keep covering the man going deep. Sometimes you think you can jump and knock it down, but if it's outside your reach, the result is obviously the touchdown.
Well, it was a hit show on cable and now is coming to broadcast TV. Don't miss Kira Sedgwick as the closer. That's Wednesdays at 7 starting September 30th right here on Milwaukee's My 24. Mother Mary watching at home tonight. That's one of her favorite shows. She can't wait to, that's coming to My 24. She'll be watching all the time. Well, Indian Trail making a statement here tonight.
Well, they erupted for 28 points in the third quarter against Park last week, and Coach McKay said that was a real confidence builder. They needed it.
Close to kick off, Ray and Stewart standing deep. And it's a line drive kick, and the two return men, that's Kekison, bumped into Siandre Stewart, and it's not going anywhere. And it's getting bad to worse here for Tremper on special teams.
Unfortunately, right now, as you watch the body language of Tremper, they've got that look of, oh my God, is the roof going to cave in? They have to find a way to respond. You can see right now, they unsure as just who was going to go in front of whom. General rule, the ball carrier is going in front. The guy receiving or faking getting the ball goes behind.
Davian Nixon was there on special teams for Indian Trailers. Mike McKay, the head football coach at Indian Trail. First and 10 for Tremper. Ball at their own 18-yard line. Out of the I formation. Peterson stacked up. A lot of black jerseys on that football there for the defense for the Hawks.
And one of the guys you see sliding in from the outside helping the tackle, Alex Parmatier. Only weighs 185, 6'2", but Coach McKay talked about the fact that he doesn't let his size have a negative effect. Very long arms, excellent technician.
Good to see Michael Capodarco back out there too for Indian Trail. He had left in that last series with a leg injury earlier in the quarter. He is back out there at his linebacker spot. Second and 9, out of the gun. Three receivers here to the near side for the Trojans. They'll throw to the single receiver. Was thrown behind Kekison. That had a pick written all over it. The defender wasn't quite ready for it. Josie Rodriguez.
Quarterback and receiver kind of confused as to what the pattern was going to be. Was he going to do a quick out? He went on a streak. Quarterback threw the quick out. They were lucky it wasn't picked off.
Again, we want to welcome the great folks at Goodwill as a sponsor this season. When a team drives inside their opponent's 20-yard line, they have entered the power zone, brought to you by Goodwill and the power of work. The way things are going tonight, all these big plays early on. No gain on the play. Third down off the incompletion. Third down and 10. Becker rolling right under attack, and he's going to go down back at the 10-yard line. Davian Nixon was the first man to lay a hand on Becker, slowed him up, and got some help.
Yeah, when you have a frame like Davion, 6'6", 257, a tremendous reach. He can reach over the blocker and grab the quarterback.
Not much chance. Yep. Well, Ben Rollman called on here to punt out of the end zone, standing at the goal line to receive this punt. Hawks should come away with good field position. Left-footed punter Rollman gets an end-over-end kick. Defender ball get there, and it's going to be interference with the opportunity to make a fair catch, but Indian Trail picks up the ball as the defender going to take it down the near sideline. Another penalty marker goes down. As Josie Rodriguez picked up the ball after it deflected off the deep man. We've got a little laundry all over the field here. We've got five different penalty markers from all five officials on the field.
Right, you've got interference with the fair catch by Kenosha Tremper, and then you've got a block in the back. Referees were in perfect position to see that. That rule, if you see the guy's number, stop. Stand your ground.
Neil Bruner, veteran official, works a lot of college games on Saturday as well.
You've probably seen him at Carthage.
Matter of fact, when we have scrimmages at Carthage right before the season, he's one of the officials that heads up that officiating crew. He's a very nice gentleman on the sideline.
No, in order to, it'll be an offset if you accept their penalty. It'll be an offset and we'll re-kick because we got a block in the back here. So you can keep the ball, we go back 10 yards and you fall.
Explaining his options to head coach Mike McKay.
Coach McKay is saying, we're moving the ball so well.
It was an obvious interference to make the fair catch there at midfield. And then Josie Rodriguez smartly picked that ball up.
Right, demonstrating.
And started upfield.
Demonstrating he's a good runner, not just a DB.
I think there was the block in the back right there late in the picture.
There was no fair catch signal. So, as I said, if you accept their penalty, we got an offset because we got a block back here before.
Or we can take the ball.
Or you take it 10 yards back.
Again, Neil Bruner and Mike McKay still going over the options. I think what they're talking about here is whether or not they
retain the ball.
Retain possession here if there will be a re-kick.
Right, there wasn't a signal for a fair catch, and that has a bearing on.
You have to decline their penalty.
Hey, and we've got a scoreboard up and working. Not the correct time, but we've got the correct score.
They do have the score, and we do know that it's probably going to be first down and 10.
And they re-kick. Yeah, we've already. Okay. Jeff.
Neil's probably going to get his own show. He's been on camera so long. This could lead to a series.
No, and this would, I think what.
Is this yours?
If I'm a coach, what makes him a good official is he's explaining to you everything you've got in front of you here.
That's the only thing coaches want. They want communication.
Two fouls on the play.
And, Neil and his crew are going to be very administratively sound is the best way to put it.
On the return, block in the back. Another return team, that ball will be assessed from here.
So it'll be a spot foul from where the block in the back occurred at the 40, 10 yards back. We'll move it back to the 50. Let's see if we can see it. There's the interference. And then as Josie Rodriguez started upfield.
Up the sideline, you're going to see, I think,
right there.
Two different blocks in the back, matter of fact.
That late one right there. I think they're going to get the game clock adjusted here.
We have 2 minutes, 41 seconds remaining until halftime. 2 minutes, 41 seconds remaining to the second quarter. Excuse me.
Okay. So Indian Trail will keep possession here at midfield following the assessment of the blocking in the back penalty from the 40-yard line. So it'll be their ball midfield. Ian Chapman has thrown 3 touchdown passes here in this first quarter. He has 3 receivers to the left. And he wants to go to Christian Jones once again. Has some blocking out the far side, and he's wrestled down from behind near the 45-yard line of the Trojans. They're getting Ray, the cornerback on that far side, able to take him down.
Yeah, they're getting that bunch receiver look, and they're getting that little quick screen, and they're getting outside the defensive backs, and they're making yardage heading up that sideline.
2.5 minutes to go here in our first quarter. And the fake to Pretzelfinger. Chapman will keep it. First down and more. Inside the 40, down to the 34-yard line. Gain of 9 and a first down. A Wisconsin Lutheran College first down by the feet of Ian Chapman.
When you and I were watching practice on Monday, we both commented when Ian Chapman was off to the side, there were no coaches working with him. He was the coach working with the two backs.
Play fake, going for it all.
Open.
Man wide open inside the 10, into the end zone, touchdown Max Alfredson. 34-yard strike, 4 touchdown passes in the quarter for Chapman. And Indian Trail piling it on early in Kenosha tonight.
2 minutes, 13 seconds remaining.
It's like watching the tide come in. You're having no control right now, and Tremper seems at a loss in terms of having their coverage.
Michael Little, senior defensive back there. Too much cushion for Max Alfredson. Close for the extra point. It is through. 28-0, Indian Trail.
Well, the speed of the Indian Trail receivers has been impressive. The Southeast Conference, there are some outstanding teams. You know, there's some big games coming down the road. You've got an outstanding Franklin team. You've got a very good Oak Creek team. Indian Trail wants to be in that mix at the end of the year. And so far tonight, they look like they're headed in the right direction.
Both teams have Franklin and Oak Creek left on their schedule. We're going to see Tremper and Oak Creek in a couple of weeks.
Right.
But that's the game I would like. Indian Trail, Oak Creek, that match up there. Speed on speed. Coach Bartholomew has got speed up there at Oak Creek.
Yeah, both of those teams have relay teams that qualified for the state meet last spring, and it'll be like a track meet.
Once again, that's Gateway Trojans stunned here in this first quarter. Four touchdown passes thrown by Ian Chapman, two to Christian Jones. Alfredson with a touchdown, Carmichael with a touchdown reception. Coming into this game, Indian Trail had 10 touchdowns on the year, and only two players had more than one.
Well, those first two opponents, Germantown and Homestead, are quality opponents, and that's what Coach McKay wanted to do, challenge his team.
Close with the kick. Ray with some speed across the 20 out to the 27-yard line. Ray with the return. Like it was Alex Parmenteer down there on special teams making the stop for Indian Trail. And so Tremper at their own 28-yard line trying to get something going here offensively. A turnover has led to a score. Punt to midfield. Indian Trail, the big plays here tonight by Indian Trail. That's been plaguing the Trojans all season long.
Right. And right now Coach Matrice has to make sure he keeps the fellas under control.
Ben Roman now will take over at quarterback, try a running play, and they'll stuff him for no gain.
Now, if you look carefully, you count the number of men around the ball carrier, there are 10 Indian Trail Hawks.
And we've got an injured Tremper player down. And I might be Travial
Looks
Lee.
Like, yeah, 6'4", 310-pound senior.
He had just gotten him back from an injury earlier this season.
Yeah, we saw him be the lead blocker a couple times as they fed the ball to Peterson. They can ill afford to lose him. I don't know whether it's an ankle or he's got a knee brace on and kind of pointing at the knee.
Let's head downstairs. Mike, I believe, has the mayor of Kenosha with him.
He's not the mayor of Kenosha, but he's Ron Davies. When we talk about the greatest high school football coaches in the state of Wisconsin, in the history, he's in the conversation. He's also my co-host on Friday night, Scoreboard Show on 105.7 FM, The Fan. Ron, how are you?
Oh, boy, I tell you, I'm a little bit hurting tonight because Indian Trail is really good, but I feel bad for my Tremper Trojans.
No doubt. You know what? It's always good to talk to him, but that's not why we're doing the interview. My man Ben's here. Ben, how are you?
Good.
Yeah, look at that camera and smile. You're playing a little football this year?
Yes.
That's a million-dollar smile right there. Did you know your grandfather is one of the greatest high school football coaches ever in this state?
Yes.
Yeah, he's a good man. Mm-hmm. That's why I have him as my co-host, because he's so smart.
Yes.
It's a good-looking boy right there. He's not bad either, but this is the man right there. Guys, back to you.
Ben, good to meet him. We met with Ben
right
before the kickoff tonight.
Very personable young man.
Yes, he is. We take a look right there. I think he was
rolled up.
Yep, rolled up from behind. Lee was able to walk off under his own power. Loss of two, second and 12. Rollman in under center. Play fake, rolling left, throwing left, and overthrows Armani Ray.
Armani Ray, number 11.
We mentioned in the pregame show how they've used Ben Roman, wide receiver, tight end, quarterback, very good athlete. Has thrown a touchdown pass this year, matter of fact, is at the quarterback position.
He's 5 of 16 on the year passing. He's had 8 receptions this year. Does the punting. And he's going to work from the gun here. Has Peterson to his right, 3 receivers near side. Third down and 12. Then we have movement up front. Penalty on the Trojans.
Oh, false start. 52 on the offense. 5-yard penalty remains third down.
So third and 17, and that's the other part of the equation, the penalties, the mental part here for Tremper the first 3 weeks of the season.
Now this is where Frank Matrice has to play the role of psychologist to be able to keep his team's mind in the game and moving in a positive direction.
So third and 17, ball just across the 20-yard line. Roman over the middle, and it's going to be intercepted. Picked off at midfield with the reception back there defensively. It was Andrew Masters, the safety, again overled the receiver by a good 5 or 6 yards, and Masters with the pick, second turnover tonight by the Trojans.
You know, Tremper has had trouble scoring this year, and you can see right now their offense just isn't clicking. Threw off his back foot, hung it up there.
Looking for Armani Ray, the split end, and led him, and Masters with the pick. This is Jones with the run. And he'll take it out of bounds into Trojan territory just short of the 45-yard line, and we've got an injured Tremper player now down at the Indian Trail sideline.
Not quite sure what happened. I don't know if we'll get a replay of that, but it was a boy going as he was headed out of bounds from Tremper. Looks like he maybe got the wind knocked out of him the way he's situated there. On the
so things going from bad to worse in a hurry. We're still in the first quarter, 28-0. Indian Trail on top of Tremper. Second injured player for the Trojans tonight. They had just lost Travial Lee earlier. Once again, let's head to the sideline and Mike McGivern.
Hey, guys, you know who I found on the sidelines? The player of the year last year in this conference, Lane Oaks, quarterback here at Indian Trail. It's good to see you.
Thank you. It's good to see you, too.
So I asked Lane, how much do you miss this? He said, man, I miss it a lot. You know, you knew how much you loved high school football, but this just makes it harder.
Yeah, it's tough, man. I just want to get out there and play with them right now. It sucks.
He's got no eligibility left. He still throws a good ball. Where are you now? You're in college?
Yeah, I'm at Triton College. This is junior college in River Grove. I'm playing baseball there, so.
No football?
No.
No, dude, he misses it. I'm just telling you, he was a great player, and he was fun to watch. And, again, the player of the year in this conference, a lot of good players in this conference. This kid was the best last year. It's good to see you.
Thank you. Good to see you, too.
You bet. Back to you, boys.
Mike, thank you. Good to see Lane Oaks here tonight.
Well, Lane Oaks actually replaced Ian Chapman last year. Ian was slated to be the starting quarterback, was injured the very first game. Lane Oaks came in and obviously had himself a pretty good year, player of the year in the conference. Fantastic athlete. When you watched him throw the ball last year, he had amazing scrambling ability. He looked like he'd be dead to rights, totally reversed the field, gain yards.
Take one more look at our replay. Oh, right there. May have gotten kicked in the... Yeah, right there.
I think 17 was actually blocked and driven out of bounds and went sliding, and I can't tell if he's... Seems like he's getting to his feet right now.
Ricky Edwards. And you can tune in online to our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights this season. Log on to my24milwaukee.com. Click on the Thursday Night Lights link. You can also find complete game videos and photos from this season's games. That's my24milwaukee.com. Good sign there. Ricky Edwards up under his own power.
His teammates come over to encourage him, and I think one of those things, you find yourself down 28-0. Sometimes things start to feel even worse. It just compounds your problems.
So Edwards making his way to the far sideline. Indian Trail facing a second down and 7. Ball at the Trojan 46-yard line. Minute 24 to go, first quarter. So Chapman already thrown for 4 touchdowns here in the quarter. Will work out of the gun. And look near side, completes here near side. Gabe Toronto. Toronto with the catch inside the 35. They'll mark him out at the 33. Gain of 13. Another Wisconsin Lutheran College first down.
Only a sophomore. Coach McKay said he actually has the best hands on the team. Well, there's a number of nominees for that title.
First and 10, Hawks. Jones trying to go up the middle, slowed down and brought down. 3-yard gain down to the 30-yard line. Looked like Kyle Griffin was there along with Dante Genicaro.
Kyle, one of the captains for Tremper this season.
Gain of 3, second and 7 from the 30. Play action fake, Chapman will keep it. Trying to get up the middle and is hauled down from behind. Again, Genicaro got a piece of him, slowed him up as he got across the line of scrimmage.
Once again, Ian Chapman is reading. Are they crashing on the ball carrier? So he tucks it back in, follows behind Big Ben Bingham.
Again, throws it out here near side. Once again, to Toronto, makes the first man miss inside the 15 and thrown out of bounds. Near the 11-yard line, Gabe Toronto, second straight reception on this drive. Just a sophomore, his 8th reception of the year.
Yeah, 6'1", 165 pounds. Actually looks a little heavier than that.
Griffin wrestled him to the turf. Chapman going for 5 touchdowns. Would have had it, but the receiver dropped the football on a slant route, skinny post, whatever you want to call it. Carmichael will tell you he should have had it. Armani Carmichael looked upfield before the ball got in.
Might have been counting 6. Yeah, that's only his 2nd incomplete pass on the entire evening.
They'll go 3 wide to the left side. 9 seconds to go in the quarter. Low snap, Chapman picks it up. Looks for Toronto again, interfered with as the flags come down. Kekeson was out there. I think it's going to go on Kekeson right there. You see the left arm up the back of Toronto that time. Riley Kekeson, the junior, multi-sport athlete here at Tremper.
What number was that?
Getting some looks from the Service Academy. He's an excellent student. Also some of the teams out of the MAC conference.
Half the distance to the goal
line.
Only
a junior.
Repeat second down.
Good range, 6'3", 155 pounds.
So half the distance to the goal. They'll move it down inside the 7-yard line, just shy of the 6. We're in the Goodwill Power Zone, the power of work. Chapman will hand it off. Coming around the left side, penalty marker down. Running it into the end zone for the score for Indian Trail. That was Andrew Masters, but let's hold it here. Laundry on the field. And then we'll come back for a hold.
One of those linemen that was celebrating raised his hands in the air. That was also maybe saying, no, I really didn't hold, Mr. Official.
Play clock, or game clock showing 0s here, so the holding call will be enforced. And I believe they'll have to run one more play here in the quarter. quarter can end on a penalty. So they'll move the ball back out to the 17-yard line. And let's see, are they going to end the quarter here or not? There was some confusion on the part of the officiating crew.
One
on time down is what we'll have here. So still with a chance to throw five touchdown passes in a quarter here is Chapman.
The opening quarter, that's the disheartening thing for the Tremper Trojans.
I think they're going to make sure that the Tremper sideline knows that it's an untimed down. Chapman from the gun. Some time. Now scrambles up the middle, and he's going to be buried at the 15-yard line. Now our first quarter comes to an end. Ian Chapman with quite the quarter. Four touchdown passes, two of them to Christian Jones. And Indian Trail Hawks lead the Trojans 28-0. Our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My24.28-0, Indian Trail on top of Tremper. Hawks right to left here in this start of the second quarter. John Weiser, Terry Kelly, Mike McGivern, and Kara and our fine crew here with you in Kenosha tonight. Fade route back of the end zone. It is incomplete, out of bounds. Kekeson made the catch for the interception but did not get his feet in. Good coverage that time by Kekeson.
Looks like Coach McKay is going to opt to try the field goal. Good opportunity them to practice their kicking game.
Pass intended for Gabe Toronto, featuring Toronto on that drive here for the Hawks. So this will be a 32-yard attempt, middle of the field, for Close. Chapman will put it down. Close gets it up, and no good. Short and to the right. So a field goal attempt, short and to the right, and Tremper will get the ball back. We'll see if that puts a little more life in the Trojans here. We were noting during that timeout a lot of arms folded and heads down on that Trojan sideline after that first quarter.
Right, they've had a couple players get injured. Once again, your psyche gets destroyed like that in that opening quarter. So Coach Matrice probably trying to call them together in between the quarters, see if we can somehow rally, take some pride, get a score.
Ball we spotted at the 20-yard line, first and 10, Tremper. Ben Rollman back in at quarterback, second drive here for Rollman. He will work from the gun, and he will throw downfield over the middle, picked off again. Second straight interception by Andrew Masters across midfield, across the 40, 35, 30. Still on his feet, cuts it back sideline inside the 10, and he will get it in the end zone for the touchdown. However, penalty marker on the play. This one will be coming back for a block in the back again. Flag down at the 30-yard line as we take a look once again. Rollman, a lot of air under that one, lofting it out there.
Yeah, demonstrating he has a strong arm, but unfortunately overthrew the receiver.
Evan Wisniewski was the intended receiver. Masters, his second pick of the night. However, block in the back. Hawks will keep possession. They'll step it off from the spot of the foul. They'll move it back to the 40-yard line where the Hawks will take over at the Trojan 40. We're just underway, second quarter. That's pretty much been the evening tonight if you're a Trojan fan.
And Coach McKay really can't afford to have his guys kind of pull back and call off what they're trying to do offensively. They need to make sure that they're running their offense well.
Three receivers to the right. Chapman with time, going for the home run, and nobody there. Incomplete. Max Alfredson was the intended target as we head downstairs once again to Mike McGivern.
A couple of things, guys. Number 10, Michael Carpodarco is out, I think. High ankle sprain. Don't think he's playing anymore. And I got a new favorite coach, the offensive line coach here at Indian Trail, Coach Otto. Coaches these boys up. Kind of guy that some old school boys would like to play for.
Chapman, short gain to Armani Carmichael. Mike, we thank you. All season long, Mike and Kara will have the opportunity to talk with sponsors, coaches, and other guests down on the sidelines, letting you know about the great things going on in the schools and communities such as Kenosha. Our sideline reports are being brought to you by Menards. Save big money at Menards. Third and five, Chapman, slant over the middle, complete to Alfredson. Alfredson inside the five, stopped at the three. 32-yard pickup for Alfredson. It'll be first and goal, Indian Trail in the Goodwill Power Zone.
Alfredson once again on the tackle. Alfredson on the reception. That brings up a first and goal.
Just a nice slant route that time, run well. Kekeson finally brought him down. Pretzelfinger breaking tackles into the end zone. Touchdown, Indian Trail. Josh Pretzelfinger with the touchdown run.
One of the things that Indian Trail did that time, they brought number six, Brian Roach, a defensive lineman, in to be the lead blocker on that play. You know, is it lineman? He's 6'2", 232. Gives you the advantage of another lineman playing for you, leading the way for Pretzelfinger.
Second touchdown of the year for Pretzelfinger. A 5'7 senior. Chapman on the hold for the extra point by Close. It is up and it is good. 35-0 in favor of Indian Trail. I mentioned in this series, this is Indian Trail only in existence for 4 years as a varsity program. They've won all three games, but the last two have been close. Last year came down to a fake punt inside the 20 with 2 minutes left that Lane Oaks was able to execute, and Indian Trail able to hold on to a 29-24 victory. The year before that was a three-point victory in favor of Indian Trail.
From inside their own 20 when they did that. Yes. That was the amazing thing.
Once again, down to the sideline and Kara.
Thanks, guys. I've got Sergeant Ebert with me with the United States Marine Corps. Now, you're the first Marine in your family. How did your family feel about that?
You know, they were pretty proud. I had a great-grandpa in the Army who was in World War I, and then I had a grandpa in Vietnam, uncle in the Navy. So when I told them I was going to be a Marine, they were kind of shell-shocked, but now everybody's flying Marine Corps flags at the house. They got Marine Corps stickers on the vehicles. They couldn't be prouder.
And what are the benefits of joining the Marine Corps?
All right, so on top of the financial security of already always getting paid on the 1st and the 15th, we have good educational benefits. But the things a lot of kids don't know is the travel. You're going to travel all over the United States, and the crowd's really getting rowdy. You're going to make lifelong friendships. I've got guys I've only known for a couple years in the Marine Corps, and I talk to them more than guys I knew all through high school. So the friendship and the camaraderie is huge in the Marine Corps.
Well, thank you so much for all that you do and for your service and for joining us for Thursday Night Lights. Back to you.
All right, thank you, Kara. Stewart and Ray deep, and it'll be an onside kick here. It'll bounce around through the first wave. It'll be picked up here by Ray coming around the near side at the 25, and that's as far as he'll get. Hawks got the coverage unit down there. So take a look at the last drive by the Indian Trail Hawks.
Ray with the return. Granucci on the tackle.
Five plays, just under a minute. 2 yard touchdown run by Josh Pretzelfinger. You know, the Trojans get in their huddle and they're short a player. Looks like it's going to be Becker back at quarterback here now for the Trojans. Peterson will get the handoff across the line of scrimmage, and he's stacked up and driven down. Well, they floated the ball so quickly. There were four Indian Trail Hawks there led by Jacob Zarafanian.
Andrew Masters came up from his defensive back position, helped get in on the stop as well.
Zarifian, I'll get it right. Been working on that one all week, and I still blew it. Oh, well. Only been doing this for 35, close to 40 years, right?
Well, actually, the crew that got you started is just down the booth
They are. Yes, they are. It all started one day back in 1980, yeah. Gain of one, second down and nine. Out of the I formation. Play action fake to Peterson. Becker under pressure. Down he goes, back at the 22-yard line. Nowhere to go as he went with the play action fake as he was trying to set up the throw. An avalanche of Hawks that time, collapsing the pocket. Alex Parmentier leading the charge for the Hawks.
Yeah, that long-armed gentleman that Mike McKay, who serves also as the defensive coordinator, mentioned to us. And Jim Camerata, longtime coach at a variety of Kenosha schools, works with the linebackers. So obviously you've got some wonderful defensive minds working together for the Hawks.
Once again, the Trojans facing third and long, third and 12. In the second quarter. Becker is trying to step up. He'll be sacked again back inside the 20-yard line.
That's one of your proverbial coverage sacks as well, as you saw the DBs cover up all four of the receivers for Tremper.
Benizek in there on the sack. So back-to-back sacks drive the Trojans back inside the 20, and Ben Roman on to punt.
Banaszak, another nice rangy player, 6'4", 235, a junior.
Again, they're short a player here on special teams. So Kekeson will come on out. High snap. Roman will get a good foot into this one. It will drift over the deep man. It'll roll inside the 35 and roll dead inside the 30.
That's another nice punt by number two, Roman of the Trojans.
50-yard punt right there for Ben Roman.
You know, we've mentioned Roman being an excellent athlete, and his rugby-style punting has probably been the only positive so far this evening for Tremper.
Durzan and Menard is our Scholar Athlete Award sponsor this season, so coming up at halftime, we'll bring you the Scholar Athlete Awards. Kara will have a chance to talk to Bob Menard from Durzan and Menard, along with a few of our other sponsors. That's coming up during our American Family Insurance halftime report. 35-0 Indian Trail. Coming around the near side is Jones. Christian Jones with a pair of touchdown receptions tonight, this time running the football.
I think that's the first time this evening that they've had two backs back in that spread offense with the quarterback. I would imagine they're going to try to work a little bit on their run game now. I think also Coach McKay is not looking to victimize Tremper either.
Gain of six, second and four from the 35. Toss it out to Jones, and Jones steps out of the tackle by Ray, moves it up the sideline, gets it to the 40 before he's crushed there. Very close to a first down. Griffin finished him off that time, and Griffin, one of those guys that's got the motor running 24-7.
Right, and Chapman, he's throwing long, he's throwing short, on the mark.
You see Christian Jones with that good strength there to fight off Ray. Get the extra yardage. It'll be a Wisconsin Lutheran College first down at the 41-yard line. Pritzelfinger gets the carry out to the 45-yard line. Gain of about four on the play for Josh Pritzelfinger. Scored a touchdown earlier tonight.
Good change of direction that time by Pritzelfinger.
Again, the Hawks in a hurry up. They get to the line of scrimmage, they call the play, and they go. Pritzelfinger gets the call again here through traffic. Still on his feet across the 45 out to the 47-yard line. It only goes for a gain of two, but boy, he should have been stopped behind the line. Fought off three different tackles before he was finally brought down by Kekeson.
For a 164-pounder, he runs very hard. He's not going to go down easily.
Third and short. Long two here for Indian Trail. Chapman muffed the snap. He'll just go back and fall on it.
Recovered by Chapman.
Covered up by Griffin that time.
Griffin with the tackle.
So a bad snap will force Indian Trail into their first punt tonight.
You know, Coach McKay really likes his team. He says, you know, it was misleading to look at their first two games, that they were actually in scoring position, made some mistakes against both Homestead and Germantown, so their 1-2 record's a little deceiving.
See Andre Stewart dropping deep here for Tremper. Close, who also doubles up as the punter. Kicks one there. It is bobbled momentarily and then covered up by the Trojans. We'll take a break here. Mid-quarter break, 4:06 to go in the half. Indian Trail in control, 35-0 over Tremper. Our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My24. Ian Chapman throwing four touchdown passes in the first quarter tonight as the Hawks lead the Trojans 35-0. Kenosha's west side tonight, Indian Trail Academy, Jaskiewicz Stadium. Becker, play action, pumps, now gets up field across the 40 out to the 41-yard line.
Parmentier,
we've called his name a couple of times here in this half for Indian Trail on the stop.
Extremely mobile, gets around real well.
Alec Becker, a 6'1", 190-pound junior, completed 52% of his passes this season coming into the game. He was 13 for 25 and 108 yards and a touchdown last week against Horlick in the 14-6 loss to the Rebels. Three receivers to the left on second and long. And Peterson will take the direct snap. Fumbles the football. It's loose near the 40. And I believe he got it back. I'm not sure if he was to take that snap or if that was going to be a handoff by Becker. There was confusion back in the backfield on the exchange. Let's take another look. And Peterson, so he was fighting for extra yardage, and the ball squirted out. Third and long, let's head downstairs to Mike McGivern.
Hey guys, during the TV timeout, listen to Coach McKay address his defense. He said, look, if there's any cheap shots either way, he goes, you don't retaliate. Get up and do some class. Show some class on the sidelines. Show some class in the huddle. Nothing dirty on this play.
Third and long, here they come on the blitz, and down goes Becker back at the 35-yard line.
Parmentier
on the rush end that time was a stand-up end, came in clean on Becker.
Yeah, they didn't account for him. Their offensive right side had a slide to the outside. They had to make that blocking call so they can pick off that end.
It was Josie Rodriguez also there. It was Rodriguez from the near side coming in clean.
Coach Matrice talked about they needed to take advantage of the aggressive Indian Trail defense by using some draws, some screens, but in the position they're in now, trailing by 35 points, doesn't become your prime weapon.
Alfredson will let it bounce out of bounds inside the 20. Another good punt by Ben Rollman tonight as it rolls out of bounds at the 18-yard line. Second one inside the 20. For all of the info on the green and gold, including special guests and players and more, watch Locker Room. That's Tuesday nights at 6:30. In your place for sports, My24. Pep Band view tonight. That's how they're watching it. Hawks Pep Band, 35-0 Indian Trail, minute 12 to go in the half. Chapman is going to go down. Wrestled down nicely there. This time it was the other outside linebacker, Gennacaro, Dante Gennacaro, the sophomore.
Yeah, only a sophomore, 5'10", 165-pounder.
Seven tackles and a sack tonight now for Gennacaro. Loss of seven, second and 17, 44 seconds to go in the half. This time they'll hand it off. Christian Jones coming around the near side. Gets through an Armani Ray tackle across the 15 out to the 17-yard line. Ray able to take Jones down, and Jones cramped up here a little bit, looking for some help here. Going to stay in there as they're going to, under 20 seconds to go, they may not elect to snap the ball here.
Right, that last play, we saw Tremper bring three linebackers just trying to put some pressure on the Hawks.
And the Hawks will stay in the huddle. They'll take it into the locker room here as our first half comes to an end. Four touchdown tosses from Chapman, two to that guy, number three, Christian Jones, in the first quarter here tonight. One more look at Jones as he was coming around the near side. Just as he'd made the cut and was tackled right there, you can see kind of favoring that left leg, that left calf, yeah, as Armani Ray made the stop. 35-0. Hawks on top of the Trojans. Our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My24. And welcome into our halftime report brought to you by American Family Insurance. We're at Jaskiewicz Stadium in Kenosha. Indian Trail leading Kenosha Tremper by a score of 35-0. Tonight we would like to highlight two special student athletes. The law offices of Derzon and Menard and My24 are proud to present our Student Athlete of the Week nominees. From Kenosha Tremper, this week's Derzon and Menard Scholar Athlete nominee is Kyle Richter. Kyle competes in football and baseball. He carries a 4.524 GPA. He was selected all-conference and is a two-year starter. Kyle is involved in his church, youth groups, and he's the Citizenship Award winner. Eats lunch with the disabled students, and Coach Matrice remarked, quote, he is what you would want in a student athlete. Navy and Army are recruiting him to play football. And from Indian Trail, our school, Indian Trail High School, I should say, our Derzon and Menard High School athlete nominee is Allison Laurent. She competes in volleyball and soccer and carries a 3.94 GPA. Allison has been a three-year varsity player in both sports and volleyball captain for 2 years. She's a member of the National Honor Society, and she's very active in her church as well as middle school mentor and volunteers with the Special Olympics. Tonight's student athlete nominees will be in the running to receive a scholarship thanks to the great folks at the law offices of Derzon and Menard at the end of the season. Let's head down to the sideline with Karen, our special guest.
I've got Bob Menard down here with me from the law offices of Derzon and Menard. Now, Bob, this is the second time, or the first time of two games that we'll be in Kenosha for. Why is it important for you to be in Kenosha?
Well, it's really important for us to come down here. First of all, what a beautiful evening we have here tonight in a fantastic facility. This is the first time that I've personally been down here to Kenosha Indian Trail to watch the football game down here and to highlight our student athletes from both Kenosha Indian Trail and Kenosha Tremper. And it's important for us to expand beyond just the Milwaukee area because we do have a lot of clients in the Kenosha Racine area. And it's important for our firm, Derzon and Menard, to at least thank the people from these communities and hopefully give back to them through our student athlete program.
And can you tell us a little bit about the law offices of Derzon and Menard?
Well, we're a law firm that specializes in worker compensation and automobile accidents. And if you are injured at work or involved in a car accident, please give us a call and we'll take care of you.
And where can they get that information to contact you?
They can call us at 414-276-2100, or they can visit us on our web at derzon-menard.com. And remember, we work for the average Joe.
Well, thank you so much for all of your support all season long, Bob.
Well, thank you so much for having us.
Back to you guys upstairs.
Bob Menard and Kara, thank you so much. 35-0 Indian Trail on top of Kenosha Tremper. Our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights continues right after this on My24. Welcome back to the American Family Insurance Halftime Report here on the Badger Max Thursday Night Lights, brought to you by American Family Insurance. 35-0 Indian Trail all over Kenosha Tremper in that first half as Ian Chapman threw for four touchdowns in the first quarter. Let's head down to the sideline. Very special guest once again with Kara.
Thanks again, guys. I've got Kevin from our title sponsor, Badger Max, with me. Now, you guys are heavily involved in Thursday Night Lights, but what other community events do you guys get involved in?
Well, Kara, recently we've done a couple of CrossFit events across the state of Wisconsin, which has been great. I think our high pH water, obviously our lower calorie hydration with the sport drink has been a great help for them. So we're doing some other things with that. Community events in terms of a lot of the high schools with concessions we're helping out to raise money, so it's been really great for us right now.
Now, people might have the impression that Badger Max is just for athletes. Is it for other people?
Well, it's not strictly for athletes. It's always great for athletes to have a better hydration aspect, something lower calorie, but you know, anybody that's going to do any kind of athletic event or just even just walking, trying to stay in shape, it's a better for you product, and we want to make sure we have a good one for everybody.
And I want to talk about the trophy for just a second. You guys have been carrying around this 65-pound trophy for who knows how long, but it's moving from game to game, week to week. Can you tell us the story behind that?
Well, the trophy, we wanted to do something really unique. And I think Andrew did a great job of capturing unique. Obviously, as Terry jokes about with us, it is heavy. It's tough for us to get, but with the younger kids, as we announce the team of the game and the winning team, they get excited about it. And I think it's something different, but also exciting that the kids get excited about. So it was a great idea. It was well done.
Well, we are so glad that you are here with us the entire season long, and thanks so much for joining me today.
Thank you very much, Kara.
And back to you guys.
Kara and Kevin, thank you. And we thank Badger Max for our title sponsor this season on Thursday Night Lights. 35-0 Indian Trail on top of Tremper. Back with more of our American Family Insurance Halftime Report right after this on My24. The American Family Insurance Halftime Report continues here on our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights from Kenosha tonight, Jaskiewicz Stadium, home of the Indian Trail Hawks, and the homestanding Hawks burying the Trojans in that first half by a score of 35-0. Our very special Army sideline interview, here's Kara.
I've got Sergeant First Class Mopal with me. Now, what are the qualifications for joining the Army?
So, Kara, the qualifications for joining the Army are you must be 17, between the ages of 17 and 34, and be on good standing and graduating from high school, or graduate from high school, good health, and good moral standing.
And what would you say are the benefits for joining the Army?
There's many benefits. One of the biggest benefits for being active duty, which is full-time, is Montgomery GI Bill, which can be up to $61,000 in college benefits, as well as eligible for bonuses. There's also the Army Reserves, which is part-time, also able to get Montgomery GI Bill for up to $25,000. And having those qualities that you can be a camaraderie with fellow service members and serving your community.
And where can folks get any information if they're considering joining?
Yes, well, in this area, the Kenosha area, we're actually located out by Woodman's or Dickie's Barbecue, right off Interstate I-94.
And they can always
find us on GoArmy.com and check us out there, and then find your local recruiter that way as well.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much for joining us and for all that you and the Army does for our country.
Thanks. We appreciate it so much.
And back to you.
Kara and Staff Sergeant James Monpas, thank you so much. Our U.S. Army interview leads us into our U.S. Army highlight package brought to you by the United States Army. Army strong, and it was Ian Chapman strong in that first quarter tonight. Four touchdown passes. Here's the first one. Christian Jones with his first of two touchdown receptions. That one, a 63-yarder. Get things started. Third play from scrimmage.
Put a lot of air under the ball. Allow Jones to run right under it.
And Jones again on a nice little swing pass this time, showing you his burst of speed.
You could see that the safety came across, had the angle, and Jones sprinted right past him.
So 14-0 at that point in favor of Indian Trail. Chapman spreading the ball around now as he gets this one just over Armani Ray into the hands of Armani Carmichael.
Yeah, that was the player they wanted to see have a breakout game.
So Carmichael with a touchdown reception. Why not share it some more? How about Max Alfredson? Beautifully caught, beautifully thrown ball. Alfredson getting into the end zone. At that point, 28-0 in favor of Indian Trail. And then on the ground, Josh Pritzelfinger.
So happy birthday
3-yard touchdown run. That's where we stand, 35-0, and the stats don't lie with the score on the board.
Well, I'm pretty sure offensive coordinator Jack Musha might be asking for a raise after the first half. Pretty sure Coach McKay is going to say, well, let's wait a second. We'll see whether you continue to roll.
And on that other sideline, I think what you're looking for here, Frank Matrice got to get some guys to step up here in this second half. This is where you're going to see who's going to lead this team now the rest of the season, how they play here in this second half.
He has to get some positives in this half. You know, whether or not you're going to be able to come back and win the game, you know, that remains to be seen, obviously. But what, at the very least, you have to have some things you can point to and have some pride in having done well.
35-0 in favor of Indian Trail. Our third quarter coming up next, our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights from Kenosha Indian Trail High School. Welcome back to Jaskiewicz Stadium, Kenosha's West Side Indian Trail Academy. The Hawks leading Kenosha Tremper 35-0 as we get set to start our third quarter. We will have a running clock to begin our third quarter here tonight. Well, tonight's Badger Max secret word is drink, D-R-I-N-K. Enter now on my24milwaukee.com. Go to the website and you get a chance to win Badgers football VIP package from Badger Max and My24. Enter tonight's secret word, drink, to my24milwaukee.com. Good luck for those of you at home and watching on the web here tonight. With Terry Kelly, John Weiser, Kara, and Mike McGivern in our fabulous My24 crew. Great to be back in the backyard again here in Kenosha.
Well, you were able to just work a little longer at the desk today, drive over here from Carthage College.
Just a little bit longer, you got it. Long enough to get one more student enrolled. It's the way we roll.
I'm sure we want the college president to hear that comment.
Absolutely. It's called job security.
Well, Coach McKay, you know, last year, Indian Trail, you start and think, here we've had a school in existence for about 5 years, 4 years of varsity football. They got to the second round of the playoffs where they went out against Marquette. So I'm sure what he's talking to his players about, okay, we've got a lead, but so what? We're playing now to get better each and every play, each and every game, and it's building towards those critical games. Now, next week, maybe not as much of a challenge, but down the road there could be.
Well, and he talked at practice this week on Monday when we had a chance to visit with him, too, trying to get some consistency. He was not happy with the way things went. Second half of that Park game is where things started to gel here for the Indian Trail offense. They got a punt return for a touchdown, a kickoff return for a touchdown in that start the third quarter, and that got the team on a roll, and he was hoping that would continue here from the start of the ball game and not having to wait till halftime to peel the paint off the wall, so to speak, in that Park game last week.
Well, he told us he thought his guys were trying to do too much. They were looking to do other guys' jobs. And he said, no, you have to concentrate on what your specific assignment is. You do that, 10 guys in addition to you. Now we got 11 hitting on the same cylinder.
Close will kick it off to start our third quarter. And it'll be picked up at the 25-yard line here. Taking out across the near the 40. Evan Cressy that time. The short man able to return it. So Tremper will have it first and 10, just shy of their own 40. Again, we'll have a running clock here in this third quarter with a 35-point rule in effect. Our first time this year on our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights.
And this probably is the best starting position Tremper's had the whole evening. So they need to take advantage of it, trying to see what can go. And it's good to see that Travail Lee is back in the game at left tackle.
Peterson will line up and tailback. Becker will work from the gun. Slot receiver here to the near side. And Becker will run. Gets it across the line of scrimmage to the 40, where he is stacked up and driven back there. Roach, Banizak, Nixon, and Parmentier up front for Indian Trail. Linebackers Capodarco, Zarifian, and Close, and a secondary of Rodriguez, Wayand, Masters, and Smith. The defense for Indian Trail. Up front for the Trojans, Travail Lee back at left tackle, Kyle Eckelberg at left guard, Kyle Richter at center, Nathan Bianan at right guard, and Halas Zakatansky at the right tackle.
So far they have not had much luck, Tremper, in getting drive off the ball. They've had a few runs by Peterson, but they just haven't been able to make a consistent offensive push.
Ray in single coverage here on the near side. They'll swing pass out to Peterson, makes the catch. First man misses across the 45. Peterson, he'll take it out to midfield for a Wisconsin Lutheran College first down.
There's one of those positives that Frank Matrice needs to see his players demonstrate. And Peterson has been really the offense this evening for Tremper.
In motion out of the backfield, a nice little swing pass in stride. We'll get the first down, and again, this season first downs are sponsored by Wisconsin Lutheran College, located in Milwaukee, a comprehensive Christian college offering 37 undergraduate majors, an accelerated degree completion program for adult learners, and graduate degree options. Learn more at wlc.edu. First and 10 Trojans at the 49 of the Hawks. From the gun, Becker will swing it out and dropped. Man open, Armani Ray. Right through his hands and complete.
They've got to get those so they're not getting in second and long situations and allowing to have Indian Trail be that aggressive defense that Coach Matrice feared.
So second and 10 from the 49.
It'll be second and 10 for the Trojans.
Rollman and Ray split out to the right side here for the Trojans. I formation, Becker in under center, give to Peterson, the tailback. Peterson taking tacklers with him inside the 45, down to the 44, gain of five, third and about five upcoming for the Trojans, brought down by Tyler Securus, the senior outside linebacker. So third and five here for the Trojans.
Davion Nixon back into the game for Indian Trail. Very mobile defensive line for the Hawks.
From the 44, fumble on the exchange. It's picked up by Peterson. He's going to be thrown down in the backfield for a loss. Parmentier, Alex Parmentier was right there, and that's the second time tonight Becker and his center Richter have misfired on the snap.
Sometimes things just don't seem to go breaking. It's almost as if the pulling guard got in the way of the snap.
It's the second sack tonight for Parmentier. So the Trojan drive stalls at midfield. Ben Rollman on to punt this one away for Tremper. Left-footed kick, end over end. And fair catch made for Alfredson. Spot it at the 17-yard line. That's where the Hawks will get it here. 7.5 minutes running clock going here in this third quarter. And the Hawks leading the Trojans 35-0. Going to remind you that Badger Max Thursday Night Lights is available streaming live online. Log on to my24milwaukee.com. Click on the Thursday Night Lights link. You can also find a complete game, videos, and photos from our season's games, my24milwaukee.com. First offensive possession for the Hawks here in the second half. They're short a player. That's not a good way to start that second half. Rothweiler, a late man coming in. Pritzelfinger dodging tacklers across the 20 out to the 22-yard line. Once again, Kyle Griffin there. Well, he has been a workhorse on defense tonight. Griffin, 6'1", 195, a senior.
You know, and as time goes flying by, as we get near that 6:30 mark, you don't have time, Tremper, to get back in the game, so you've got to get some stops, give your offense some chances to get on the board.
Trojans showing blitz. Here they come up the middle, and they get to the quarterback. Chapman for a sack back at the 15-yard line. They sent the kitchen sink that time on the blitz.
Yeah, and Griffin got in there once again. Kyle Griffin, one of the captains this year for the Tremper team.
Yeah, that was Griffin. Yep, Griffin, that's his seventh tackle tonight, first sack of the night for Griffin. So third and 10. Ball back at the original line of scrimmage. Chapman to throw, far side, and it is deflected, incomplete. Ray and Carmichael. Both got there at the same time. So Tremper gets the stop here on 4th and 10. Leading him right into the corner that time. Goes for an incomplete pass. So Tremper will get the ball back. Siandre Stewart near midfield awaiting the close punt.
Siandre Stewart back the return for the Trojans. Close off the punt.
It's a low snap. Close gets it away. Stewart will run up and let it bounce. It'll take a Hawk roll end over end. Cross midfield to the 49-yard line. We'll take our mid-quarter break here. 4:50 remaining here in this third quarter. A 35-0 Hawks lead over the Trojans. Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My24. Indian Trail, 35-0 over Kenosha Tremper. The Hawks. That's exactly what has happened here tonight. They have swooped in and taking the Trojans out of this one here, at least through the first 2.5 quarters here. See what Tremper can do in this possession. They'll work it from the gun. Becker will hand it off. And they'll stack up the back almost immediately that time.
Trojans number 42 on that carry.
New carry there for new ball carrier that time. That's Kyle Griffin now working as a tight end. That time taking it as the fullback as we head downstairs to Mike McGivern.
So, boys, at halftime, I talked to the electrician that came and fixed the scoreboard. He explained to me exactly what he did. No idea, but it was clamps and this was overriding. But he took a few minutes to explain it to me. He thinks that I knew what he was talking about. I've got no clue, but he fixed it.
Yeah, I work on this end. I don't get technical at all.
Right.
I wouldn't know where to begin. Second down and 9.
Bobbled the snap once
again.
Yeah,
they did, and then they fumble. The ball is loose, still on the turf, inside the 45-yard line, and no signal yet. Ray had the carry. It all started on the bad exchange, and as Ray got the ball from Becker, he never had control of it either. Tremper able to fall on it. So a gain of 4, third and 6 here for the Trojans.
Time flying by. We're headed towards the 3:20 mark.
Again, running clock here with a 35-point lead. So as you said, Tremper, if they want to get back into this, they've got to strike quickly. And now he jumped the neutral zone. Flag on the play. Ulysses Morales jump into the neutral zone. Don't believe it'll be enough for a first down, but it sets up a 3rd and 1 here for Tremper.
The linebacker coach, Coach Camerata, will not be pleased with giving him yardage on that play.
So it takes him from 3rd and 6 to 3rd and 1. Ball at the 41 of Indian Trail. Ray to the far side, Kekeson to the near side. And Becker will keep it. He will get the first down inside the 40 down to the 39-yard line. Becker on the keeper, keeps the drive moving here for the Trojans. Brought down by Alex Ziccarelli in there now on defense for the Hawks.
Number 57, Alex Ziccarelli on the tackle.
So another Wisconsin Lutheran College first down for the Trojans. Full forward progress down to the 38.
With Capodarco out with an ankle injury, they're trying to get a few more folks to get some experience tonight.
Ray in motion near side. Line up in a slot near side. Peterson will get the call here. Fumbles the ball. It's loose inside the 35, and it looks like the Hawks may have recovered.
There's a fumble on the play.
No signal yet. It will be Hawk football. Third turnover tonight committed by the Trojans. Josie Rodriguez with the recovery for Indian Trail. Well, it's the show featuring two adults, one kid, and no grown-ups. Don't miss Two and a Half Men, weeknights at 5 and 5:30, only on Milwaukee's My 24. Three turnovers tonight by the Trojans. Hawks will get it back now. Their own 34-yard line, final minute of play, third quarter. Pritzelfinger dodging tacklers across the 35, short of the 40. Good run that time by Pritzelfinger, zigging and zagging his way for a gain of 5.
One of Tremper's goals tonight was try to force some turnovers. Unfortunately, it's been the other way around. You know, and it's when your offense is struggling, your defense has to do something to kind of bolster you, and so far that hasn't turned out to be the case.
Second and a long 4 here for the Hawks. Again, the Trojans showing blitz. Here they come. Chapman around the outside. He'll just go down. Not sure if he intentionally slid there or if he lost his footing. It'll be short of the first down. It'll be third and short when we come back as our third quarter runs out here in Kenosha. Kenosha Indian Trail in control since the first quarter tonight. They're up 35-0 over Kenosha Tremper. Our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My 24. Head into the fourth quarter here at Jaskiewicz Stadium. 35-0 Indian Trail on top of the Trojans. John Weiser, Terry Kelly, Mike McGivern, and Karen, our My 24 crew, in Kenosha tonight. New quarterback in there now, Jared Winberg, 6'3", 170, a sophomore. He landed off Jones. Jones coming around the right side. Good coverage on the play that time. Getting in there defensively for the Trojans, Siondae Stewart. That's 5 tackles on the night for Stewart.
Yeah, he really read that quickly. Came dashing up the field. That's one of the things they've pointed out about Siondae throughout the season is how he's all over the field. And those are one of those little building points Coach Matrice and the Trojans need.
Close to punt. Stewart inside the 30.
Stewart back to return for the Trojans. Close. Punting for the Hawks.
Gets a good snap. End over end kick. Fair catch signaled for by Stewart at the 29-yard line. So Tremper will get it back. Again, we have a running clock here in this fourth quarter with the 35-point Indian Trail lead.
Indian Trail just trying to sprinkle in a number of new players. You know, one of the things, sometimes when you look out on the field and you see some numbers that you recognize, you forget that many of these teams are two platoon almost exclusively, and that's the case with Indian Trail. So especially with the linemen, they're not quite as deep in numbers with linemen, but they're trying to work some new fellas in.
Becker from the gun on first down. Griffin in motion. Snap and the give to Peterson across the 30, spinning to the 33 and driven back there. Again, I'm impressed with Indian Trail tonight. Aggressive to the ball, right to the whistle, 3-4, sometimes 5 to the man.
We mentioned a little earlier that was something they hoped, Tremper hoped to take advantage of, but the way the game is played out, they don't really have that option.
Gain of 4, second down and 6, one more look. Said there, 4 black jerseys right there.
Excellent team pursuit.
Ray goes in motion far side. Again, Peterson spins out of a tackle across the 35 before he is driven back. And again, 4 different Hawk players right there on the ball. Off the bottom of that pile for the Hawks was Brad Close.
Senior, 5'11", 197, good size. You saw Brian Roach, the defensive end, get on that play. He was a second team all-conference player a year ago. 3-year starter, 6'2", 232 pounds. Real nice size up front. The exception is their 185-pound end, Parmentier, but we've seen he is a good technician.
Roman in motion. We'll line up now in a wing. Near side. Becker under pressure. Scrambles upfield, gets turned away short of the first down, needed to make the 40. Came up about a yard shy. More look here. Got a good block there before he is driven down. R.J. Yinneral was there to make the stop. Fourth and one for the Trojans. 8:25 to go here in our fourth quarter.
Yeah, they have nothing to lose by going for it at this point. So
Becker will keep it, take the quarterback sneak across the 40 for the first down. Tremper will retain possession. Another Wisconsin Lutheran College first down.
Looks like we might be trying to have the theme of going hunting.
Uh-huh.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to announce the 50-50 raffle.
Hawk hunting, but that didn't quite work out tonight for the Tremper faithful.
A hawk became the predator.
Yeah. Peterson, the offset eye, takes it out to the 44-yard line.
Peterson again on the carry.
Wrestled down. Austin Ketchum, 5'7", senior defensive lineman in there now for the Hawks.
Peterson keeps running hard. There just aren't any gaps that are being created in that front seven against Indian Trail. But he's not throwing in the towel. He's continuing to compete. Comes out of the game now.
Well, and for Tremper, they have to be able to run the football. That helps their offense. It allows the play action to work, and you're able to throw the ball. If you can't get the ground game going, and they got behind so quickly here tonight, unable to really get that going. They'll toss it this time to Ray. Ray around the left side. Still on his feet near the first down marker and out of bounds near midfield. Armani Ray with a nice run on the toss sweep to the left side.
Yeah, they haven't done much of the toss game. Try to work that sweep play. Try to get away from that tough front four.
That number would be 791-234.
Well, it's the funniest hour on television featuring two favorite families. Watch The Simpsons and Family Guy weeknights starting at 6 on My Place for Fun, My 24. Third and one for the Trojans. And Ray again with some room. Ray cuts it back at the 40, tries to get up midfield. Ray will take it into the end zone for the touchdown. Armani Ray, 50-yard run for the Trojans. And the skunk out of the box for the Trojans. Nice run that time. And we just, you just mentioned they hadn't been getting him the ball much on the edges. And Ray able to bust it outside and then makes a nice cut right here back toward the middle of the field at the 30-yard line, and then the chase was on.
Got good vision. He saw that he had that cutback lane, took advantage of it.
Celebrated perhaps a little prematurely, just broke the plane of the goal. And the extra point is up and in by Richter. 35-7. We'll take our break from Kenosha Indian Trail on top of Tremper on My 24. Trojans on the board, a 50-yard touchdown run by Armani Ray. They've cut a 35-7, six-play drive there by the Trojans, capped off by the Ray 50-yard touchdown run. Ben Rollman will kick it off for the Trojans. And it'll be picked up by Christian Jones. Jones with a hole up the middle, has it, and he is gone. Christian Jones returns the kickoff. Back to the house.
Christian Jones.
The seam opened up between the hashes, and man, did he hit that seam hard.
by Christian Jones.
And the vapor trail once he got across midfield.
You know, you talk about some of the kick returns that can happen and how they break a game open. Well, this is a little different in the sense that Tremper had a little bit of momentum. Suddenly you kick it off, and then whoosh, all the air goes out of the balloon.
85 yards for Jones, and he outran everybody. Well, it's second week in a row, Christian Jones has a touchdown. He had a 79-yard touchdown return last week to start the third quarter against Park. As close, we'll tack on the extra point. Let's head to the sideline and Kara.
I've got John Griffiths, general manager of the Germantown store, right here with me. John, can you tell me a little bit about Menards?
Menards opened its first retail store right here in Wisconsin in 1960. Our home office is still in Eau Claire, Wisconsin. We've got over 280 stores throughout the Midwest states, and we even have 12 stores right here in the Milwaukee area.
And now, why is it important to support youth sports?
Menards has been a supporter and partner of high school sports here in Wisconsin for many years. We appreciate the hard work and dedication it takes our student athletes to achieve their goals both on the field and in the classroom, and also really appreciate how much work it takes from the community, coaching staff, and teaching staff to help them achieve their goals.
And is there anything else you would like to add?
We'd like to wish the teams of Kenosha Tremper and Kenosha Indian Trail the best of luck and hope that everyone enjoys the rest of the broadcast.
Thanks, John, and back to you.
Of course, Kara on the sideline, on location. She is all over with our Menard interview. All season long, Mike and Kara will have the opportunity to talk with sponsors, coaches, and other guests down on the sidelines, letting you know about the great things going on in the schools and communities we visit. Sideline Reports all season long, brought to you by Menards. Save big money at Menards. Bouncing kick. Sewer will take across the 30 and wrestle out of bounds there. 85-yard kickoff return. Second week in a row for Christian Jones. His third touchdown tonight. Caught a couple of touchdown passes in that first quarter. So back to a running clock now to wrap up the final 5 minutes and change here. From Jaskiewicz Stadium.
Quite a number of substitutions in now for the Hawks, trying to get their younger players a chance to get some game experience.
Yeah, they will be in Racine next week for a week 5 game against the Case Eagles. And again, I don't know if that was a bad snap or it'd be a quarterback keep out across the 33 to about the 34-yard line. New man in there now. This is Brandon Spencer, a sophomore quarterback, 5'10", 165 in there now for the Trojans.
Tremper, on the other hand, next week finds themselves going up against Racine Park, and if they head into that game, as it appears they will, down 0-2 in the conference, they've got to grab a win, start getting some momentum moving forward.
Spencer under center will turn and give. Nothing doing there. Hawks again. No less than 7, perhaps 8 Hawk defenders there on the football immediately on the carry by T.J. Hudson. Tell you what's going to be interesting, an Indian Trail Franklin matchup or an Indian Trail Oak Creek with all this speed that they've got on both sides of the ball. I'm sure they're watching tonight, and I think they're rethinking perhaps some game plans down the road.
Yeah, those will be some marquee games in the Southeastern Conference, and you know, I'm sure that what Coach McKay wants is to have his guys look at what they've done, build off that, and continue to improve.
Sophomore Spencer will hand it off again and tripped up in the backfield. Hudson goes down.
Hudson tripped up in the backfield.
Like one of the reserve linemen up front. Gabe Zarletti Prado.
Number 70, Gabe Zarletti.
As we roll under 3 minutes remaining here. Indian Trail, after starting out 0-2, wins their first two league games. And again, you know, their non-conference opponents, Germantown and Homestead. Tremper's going to fall to 0-4. They opened up tough loss against Lake Geneva Badger, a very good Badger team, expected to challenge for the Southern Lakes Conference title as Roman gets this end-over-end kick away, line drive, and it'll be downed at the 35-yard line. Antioch was their second week opponent, Antioch, Illinois, and the Siwash expected to challenge for their division state title in Illinois.
Apparently, Antioch has an outstanding running back, a number of offers already. And once again, that was a game that Coach Patrice thought they were in, and their errors, you know, let the roof cave in. And then last week, as we mentioned, what happened against Horley. So he was looking forward to this game to see if how they were going to really fare. And
Jared Wenberg at quarterback will run the draw, gets it across the 35 out to the 36-yard line. Isaac Uribe with the stop, linebacker junior. So second and eight, final 90 seconds here from Indian Trail. Very impressed with how they went about their business tonight. Very efficient in that first quarter, big plays, they went with hurry up. Four touchdown passes thrown in that first quarter by Chapman. Is on the carry, breaking it back the other way. This is Jack Granucci. Granucci, a 6-foot sophomore running back with his first carry tonight. Makes a nice run, and a Carl there to make the stop for Tremper.
And for these young guys who've been practicing hard all week, you know, this is their payback. You've been working hard, you're gonna get in the game, you're gonna get a chance to carry the ball.
And Wenberg's going to look to the sideline here. Jack Musha, his offensive coordinator, will let him know when to take the snap, and he gets it here. Out across the 40, up to about the 43-yard line, and that should do it. Hawks really no need to snap the ball here on third down. An efficient game here tonight for Indian Trail. Led 35-0 at the half. A lone Tremper bright spot, the 50-yard run by Armani Ray. But the Hawks prevail, their fourth straight win in this series as they dump the Trojans tonight 42-7. Handshakes all around. Mike McKay and the coaches meeting at the center of the field. Frank Matrice on your left, Mike McKay on the right. As Mike, the teams go through the handshake line.
Coach McKay formerly worked at Tremper, and so obviously coaches have a long-standing relationship.
So a 42-7 rout by the Hawks tonight. Indian Trail now 2-2 on the season. 2-0 in the conference. Tremper falling to 0-4, 0-2 in Southeast Conference play. We'll be back with our postgame from Jaskiewicz Stadium, the trophy presentation, and our player of the game coming up next on My24. The homestanding Hawks take care of Tremper tonight, 42-7. They go to 2-0 in league play. Trojans falling to 0-2 in conference, 0-4 on the season. But again, that first quarter really too much for the Trojans to overcome here tonight.
Two offensive explosions in a row for the Hawks. Their game park, the game tonight.
28 points in that first quarter, and that pretty much took the Trojans out of this one here tonight as we head downstairs getting set for our Player of the Game Award, and we head down to Mr. Mike McGivern.
You know, everybody's a comedian, including Mike McKay. It's awfully funny. Hey, our U.S. Army Player of the Game, number 12, Ian Chapman. I got to tell you, not a bad first quarter, young man. Well done.
Thank you, thank you. My offensive line did really good, and my receivers made some plays for me, so they did a great job.
There you go. Smart quarterback right there, thanking everybody else. You know what? 2-0 in conference, feeling pretty good about where the direction of this team.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We just got to focus on next week. So time to celebrate tonight and then get back to work tomorrow.
You got it. Congratulations, U.S. Army Player of the Game.
So, Ian, on behalf of the U.S. Army, we're presenting you with the game ball. Congratulations on the great win.
Thank you so much.
You bet.
See you, Chapman. Ben.
Tonight's Player of the Game Award brought to you by the U.S. Army. Army strong, and What a first quarter he had here tonight as he put together four touchdown passes in that first quarter as we take a look at the highlight package here.
Yeah, very nice ball here. High arch, drops that right in.
Christian Jones caught two of those touchdown passes in that first quarter. That was the first of two. There's the toss to the outside. Max Alfredson with that catch. So Ian Chapman, our player of the game, presented by Army, the U.S. Army, Army Strong, all season long by the U.S. Army, Army Strong. Once again, Mike McGivern with our trophy presentation.
Yeah, the Badger Max trophy. We're going to let Kevin from Badger Max hold this for a minute. Kevin, got a few words for Coach McKay?
Yeah, thanks, Mac. I appreciate that. 70 pounds. Coach, team, you guys did a great job tonight. You were obviously prepared for this one, and as you have been for the first few, so good luck. Congratulations on being the Badger Max trophy winner of the game tonight.
Well done. Well done, boys. Hey, a great way to start the conference. You know what? Feeling pretty good. Had a tough non-conference. You told me before the game, look, I'm feeling really good about where this team is at, where we're heading. And certainly this game, guys that are watching this are going to get scared to play you boys a little bit.
Yeah, I thought we looked explosive on offense, and defense played pretty much lights out, kind of picked up where we left off in the second half last week, and just hope to keep it rolling through the Southeast.
Hey, do you think sometime throughout the season, and maybe it happened last week, where there's kind of a tipping point where you feel like, okay, we're getting it now, we got it, we're going to move on from here?
I do, and I feel like we kind of had it last week on the defensive side, and I think the first quarter tonight was for the offensive side, and it's a confidence issue, and it's a trust issue in your teammates.
Yeah.
And I think we finally got there.
No doubt. Hey, why don't we hand that off? The 54 who said, man, I got this, no problem. Boys, here, we're going to back you up a minute. Guys, congratulations. Well done. Good job. Here we go. That was a good one, huh?
42-7, our Badger Max Thursday Night Lights winner here tonight to go to 2-0 in conference play.
Well, a wise choice sending that off to Davion Nixon. I'm sure he and Mike will probably have a liftoff after the game, just see who is the stronger player. But once again, as Coach McKay said, their defense played outstandingly. And when they're staked to that 28-0 first quarter, things can really roll.
42-7, your final here tonight. We'll take one more break, back with a final word from Jaskiewicz Stadium right after this on My24. Your final tonight, Indian Trail over Kenosha Tremper. 28 first quarter points by the Hawks put this one out of reach early. Ian Chapman throwing four touchdown passes. Christian Jones, three touchdowns tonight, including an 85-yard kick return. That sets us up for next week's Badger Max Thursday Night Lights game. We venture into the Greater Metro Conference. The Red Raiders from Tosa East taking on the Marquette Hilltoppers. Some familiar stuff going on. Coach Maz, good to see him. And I'm sure you're going to have lots of notes for that one, right, Terry?
It's all in my memory. No problem. We'll
That's next it. Thursday night at 7 here on My24. That'll wrap things up here tonight from Kenosha. For Mike McGivern and Kara, Terry Kelly, Don, our statistician, Craig, our spotter up in the booth, John Weiser, saying good night. From Kenosha, Indian Trail, 42-7 victor over Kenosha Tremper. Until next Thursday, have a great week, everyone, and thanks for tuning in to Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My24.
Badger Max Thursday Night Lights on My24 is brought to you by Badger Max Premium Sports Drinks. Drink it to the max. Menards. Save big money at Menards. Wisconsin Lutheran College. American Family Insurance. And by Durzon and Menard. They work for the average Joe. Additional support has been provided by the U.S. Army, the Marines, Goodwill, and Sports Radio 105.7 FM, The Fan.